The word rebound is now taking on a whole new meaning for Wright State University basketball player Ryan Custer.
Custer fractured his C5 vertebrae jumping into a makeshift pool at a party in Oxford in April of last year. 2 News sports anchor Hutch Connerman has the emotional follow-up on his road to recovery. Hutch.
Oh, Brooke and Mark, I wish I was here to talk about Ryan Custer hitting a game-winning shot for Wright State. But while this story involves loss, it's really a story about love.
At 6'7", Ryan Custer always could deliver a nice outside shot.
Over to Custer, he fires with one to shoot and nailed it.
Now he's working for the biggest rebound of his life.
I remember telling George on the way up to university that our lives are unchanged forever.
Ryan's road to recovery has taken him to hospitals in Chicago and Denver. Along with surgeries, Ryan received an experimental stem cell injection. But just as on the court, sometimes the ball doesn't bounce your way.
They never promised us anything. They told us if we could get one or two more levels. He's at C5, so if we could get to C6 level, which would be the wrists, or C7 level, which would be the triceps, that's a plus.
Therapy's, it's good, but it's not, I'm not progressing like I would want to, but you just gotta stay positive and hope for the best.
SWAT toward me first.
This season, Raiders victories are coming fast and furious. For Ryan here at Good Samaritan Hospital in Cincinnati, positive results come at a slower pace, but they are coming.
He works very hard at everything we ask him to do, even the stuff that at the time he thinks is impossible, but maybe 2 weeks later we're able to do it. He has rolled his eyes a few times at me, but in the world of spinal cord injury, he's really come further than I would have expected in this amount of time.
Attitude is really important, and from day one, Ryan has brought the attitude. He comes in, he does pretty much whatever you ask him to do, even if it's something new, something we haven't done before, something that seems really challenging.
There you go.
A body weakened, but bonds strengthened. Family, faith, and friends.
I went to Moeller, he went to Elder, and we hate Elder, like we do, and he got here, and I love him to death. He embodies toughness. I know he's still fighting, and he wants to be out there. We want him out there.
Sitting there, and Coach Nagy looks back, and you're just hoping he calls your name out, but it's tough, but I love seeing the guy succeed.
Not only as a player, we miss him, but, you know, we miss him just because he's not around us every day, too. Life just does not go the way you want it to go all the time, and how you respond to it, you know, is going to say everything.
Mike Latula played only one season with Ryan. The graduate transfer was in the hospital waiting room the day following the injury. You could say he's been Ryan's wingman ever since.
He's like a brother to me. He could have every excuse in the world to wake up and be down in the dumps, and you see the way he carries himself every day, given his situation, positive, keeps the same sense of humor he had. You know, when you feel like you're down in the dumps some days, you think about Ryan, you think about how he handles his situation, and your problems seem so much more minuscule.
Ryan Custer, his family, his friends, his Raiders, his medical care team. Reminders to us all that perhaps true strength resides not so much in the body, but in the spirit.
The people that have reached out to us, we are so grateful.
When you got a whole community supporting you, you know that you just got to keep fighting, and they're never going to let you down, and they're never going to turn their backs on you, and it shows how many good people there are in the world.
I told him, I said, I pray that I could take this from you. I would gladly take this paralysis for you to give your life back. And he goes, Dad, I got a great life. He goes, I'm not going to cry about it. I'm going to get on with it.
When I finished my interview, I thanked Ryan's parents for their time. George Custer smiled and said, we love talking about Ryan. I think we all know why that is.
Great story. And the irony, I think, is that if and when he makes it back to the Wright State campus, it's one of the best campuses in the nation for disabled students.
Mm-hmm. And the Custers love Wright State, that's for sure.
Amazing how things turn out. Hutch, great job. Thank you.